Good evening. In this mission control, I would like to talk about the battle of the backend between traditional database SQL and cloud database NoSQL. Particularly, I shall focus on three main points. First, the trends that are affecting the database landscape. Second, the comparison of SQL and NoSQL. And finally, practical use cases to demonstrate the desired choice between the two approaches. So recently, big data, big users, and cloud computing are the three emerging trends that have a significant impact on the database technology. For example, there are about 2.9 million of emails sent every second, or about 1.3 exabyte data sent and received by mobile internet users. To deal with the challenges of such ever-increasing data and user, cloud computing technology has evolved and gained fast popularity for its promising features. Convenient, that means we just call or click and the service is ready to use. Affordable means no upfront cost and pay-per-use model. Reliable, that means the users do not need to care about the maintenance of hardware and software, and they can focus on what they are best, that is the business. Okay, now let's see what SQL and NoSQL are and how they are different. To manage the well-structured data, for example, the data in an enterprise or an e-commerce application, there have been a lot of standard products in the market, ranging from open source to commercial SQL database software. SQL stands for Structured Query Language, which includes data definition language for correcting table view index and data manipulation language for running transaction complex query such as join or aggregate across multiple tables. SQL databases are mainly based on the relational data model, where data are organized into tables and the relationship between tables can be established by defining the foreign key constraint in one table, referring back to the primary key of another table. One of the most important features of SQL databases is its guarantee of strict consistency and integrity constraint. For example, in a banking database, when Joe performs a transfer to Mary's account, the database system guarantees that either both accounts are updated or there is no partial update in the event of hardware or software failures. However, strict consistency does not come for free. When the data in the system grow beyond the capability of a single machine, it will need to be partitioned across the machine, which will add a lot of overhead for managing distributed transactions that access the data located on different machines. In other words, enforcing strict consistency over a large-scale data will limit the performance of the database system in terms of the number of transactions per second. Fortunately, not all applications require strict consistency, and there is application that user don't mind temporary inconsistent data. As long as the data are guaranteed to be consistent eventually. For instance, in a social networking application, when Mary accepts the friend request from Joe, her friend list will be updated immediately, while the friend list of Joe could be modified at a later time. More importantly, such eventual consistency allows the improvement of system performance when dealing with large-scale data, and it is the main rationale behind NoSQL databases. Although currently there is no standard definition for NoSQL database, it is commonly interpreted as not only SQL, which are database products for supporting large-scale application and data while relaxing consistency and complex query. And NoSQL can be classified into four major categories: key value store, big table line store, document store, and graph databases. So this is a brief comparison between SQL and NoSQL. SQL is good at complex query, transaction management, and strict consistency, while NoSQL is ideal for elastic scalability, easy system management, and flexible schema. Now, let's see in which scenarios that we should use either SQL or NoSQL. This figure shows the characteristic of data being generated by modern application. As we can see, there are more and more unstructured and semi-structured data to be managed and analyzed, such as log files, click stream, blogs, and tweets. For the highly structured data, such as data in an enterprise or an e-commerce application, it can easily be managed by traditional relational SQL database, where the data are organized into tables. However, for unstructured data, for example, the graph representing the friendship relationship in a social networking application, there is fewer relationship between the user in a very large graph. And more especially, there is less need for maintaining strict consistency on the time, as we have discussed in the previous example of the friendship request between Joe and Mary. So in this case, NoSQL will be a good candidate for managing such data. Let's see another example, Facebook inboxes. The aim of this functionality is to support efficient queries such as get the top n messages given the user ID and the word, or type a head query given a user, get the words matching the prefix. Given such requirement, the data could be organized in HBase, a key-value NoSQL system, with the keys is a composite of the user ID, the word, and the message ID, and the value of the record is auxiliary information, for example, the offset of the word in the message. And the data is stored and sorted by the user ID, the word, and the message ID. And this figure is an example of the data layout that are stored in this NoSQL storage. In this way, the data related to a given user and word will be clustered together, enabling efficient processing of the type ahead query and the top end message query. However, this does not mean that NoSQL is always a good candidate. Actually, there is a trade-off in the design choice between SQL and NoSQL. Let's have a look at this example. We would like to manage the data of users and their travel trips. And in this application, the user can plan zero or more trips. The typical query in this application is first list a user trips, and we only want to display the trip destination and the photo. The second popular query is to display a trip along with user who plan it. And in this case, we only need the user ID, his name, and the photo. And the third query is to display a trip along with the traveling users. So in a SQL design, we typically have three normalized tables, including user for maintaining the user information, trips for maintaining the trip information, and the third table is travels to store information which user join in which trip. And with this database design, to perform each of the above query, we need expensive join operator across the table, and especially if the table are large and distributed across the machine, this operation will be very costly. So A NoSQL design will avoid such expensive joint operation. For example, we first denormalize the SQL database design by duplicating some of the user data in the trip table and some of the trip data into the user table. For example, in the user table here, we maintain some information of the trip that he has planned. And also at the same time, we also, in the trip information, we maintain the user information that who has planned the trip and the list of travelers that joined this trip also. So, given this NoSQL design, we can perform efficient query for the previous three popular query for this application. However, the trade-off is the system need to suffer from expensive update. That means, for example, if we want to update the trip destination for a trip that associated with three travelers, user A, B, C, in this case, the database system need to perform four operations at the same time. First, update the trip record, and then update the trip summary on user A, and the trip summary for user B and user C also. Because we have duplicated the information across different places, so when there is a modification to this information, we need to update them across different places also to ensure the eventually consistency. So to sum up, I would say that choosing between SQL and NoSQL is an ongoing debate, and in my opinion, the best solution is not either SQL or NoSQL alone, but the combination of them. For example, in a single cloud application written in Google App Engine, for example, the application can access the data managed in different types of database, which could be Cloud SQL or Data Store NoSQL or Cloud Storage, which is a binary raw storage. So in this way, we can take advantages of the different approach from SQL and NoSQL at the same time. For example, in this CrashLit application, where user can both listing and advertisement, and the system can maintain on active listing in a NoSQL database and gradually migrate on the obsolete listing to another SQL backend. Therefore, the application can maintain strict consistency for the very active listing while can support efficient query for the older listing. So this is a summary of the middle approach where we combine both SQL and NoSQL in an application. Okay, this is the more additional references that you can have a look at. And thank you for your attention.